Well, the title of this video is called Satan Roadblocking People's Souls. You know, folks, Satan is a reality. Satan does exist. And Satan is getting more and more of a grip on this planet because people, in my opinion, are succumbing to these evil and demonic powers that are to be. This morning I went out, well, I attempted to go out to Ipswich to the Bush Chapel out there because there's a place that we can go to, and there's a cross, and you can go and do some praying and console with God. I have been receiving comments of late that I'm trying to convert people to Christianity, or that I'm trying to browbeat people. That's not what my intention's about. My intention is that I wasn't happy with the person I was before, and ever since I have renewed my faith, I'm feeling a lot better in myself, but I just don't like the way a lot of things are going. When I went out this morning, I encountered roadworks on the back roads going out to Ipswich. And again, I was exposed to the shitty attitudes of the so-called road workers on the road. You know, the road was suddenly closed, and I didn't understand why. To me, it was Satan trying to look. I'm going to explain this all in a minute. But anyway, the shitty attitudes prevented me from going out to the Ipswich to the park this morning. So to turn back, because I don't want to go on the freeway. I don't want that aggression and negative energy on Australia Day or whatever. So I went out to the Rocks Riverside Park and had a walk around there. I mean, it's 26 degrees here as a minimum. It's not very pleasant for summer weather. It's very uncomfortable and unbearable. But again, I have to stress that I have been dealing with some very, very tough and challenging issues. I have had my soul attacked certain times by Satan, and in the middle of the night. On one occasion I had to pray extensively to prevent this toxicity, this demonic energy from going into my mind. And what happened was that it's hard to explain it, but it's just like trying to be pure and dealing with all this evil and negative energy. I mean, I've been attacked also recently last night, and it wasn't by Satan, but it was on the Facebook. I made a post concerning the implementation of a community idea I had here, which was to introduce a lake, horse riding, and a community environment for people to cohese. It seems to be in this world there's so much of these attacks towards the church, attacks towards decent people, attacks towards goodness and kindness, that I think that Satan is just having a field day with bringing upon evil in this world. But anyhow, I know it's not good to judge people, but one of these people on Facebook, who I will call Jet Boy, said to me that I should take a good hard look at myself, and that I call myself a Christian, and I'm a hypocrite. And when I mentioned also that I do autism advocacy, because he criticised me by saying that I was, I attacked this so-called friend of his, what it was that someone said to me, why bother posting ideas if you can't back what you're doing? Well, the very concept, the very proposal of the idea was to get community discussion. It wasn't about me wanting to try to impose my thoughts and concepts on people. It was about to get community concept input. Anyway, the critic said to me, well, I'm able to post my opinions for comment. And then that person was offended, and then the Jet Boy stepped in and criticised me and said I should delete the comments that I made, and these comments being that I had to defend myself in this situation, and said to me, I should take a good hard look at myself. Well, excuse me, I devote my time and energies towards, you know, the autism advocacy movement. I'm not a perfect people, perfect person. By far, I'm not a perfect person. But I'm not going to stand here and be attacked and criticised and persecuted and then being told that I am actually a victim when I really was stating my position. Now, I think that Facebook is often a coward's way of criticising people, because people can get on and they can post whatever they like, whatever defamatory, expletive or what vindictive comments they want on Facebook, but I don't think that they would have the guts to say it to the person's face. And this is something why I really try to avoid Facebook discussions, because it ends up that there are people that gang up against me and or up against other people. And people are so temperamental and they're so easily offended by things. But to have someone tell me I should take a hard look at myself, well, excuse me, you know, I'm not going to cop comments like that, because I'm not going to be told that I'm some sort of inferior subspecies of person for the amount of work that I do myself, the amount of crap I have to put up with left, right and centre around me. I have people that will try. I do think it is Satan. I think it's the negative energies, the toxic, demonic energies that are continuously making their way on this planet. I just don't think people really, really can look at themselves and say, am I really answerable to God? Because people are afraid that people just think that death is it. They think death is the end and that's it. The journey starts now. The goodness starts now. The strengthening of faith starts now. If you don't like what I do and you cannot handle the way that I speak, well, I'm sorry, but, you know, it's either that you join the journey that I'm on or that you take your energy somewhere else, because I just don't want issues and I don't want complications and I don't want difficulties. I want to try my best through my own means, and I'm not imposing again this on other people, to make this world a better place. But when you turn on the television set and you see all the horror and all the evil in the world, I tell you, I don't really want to be a part of it. And I think, well, if it means going to eternity sooner rather than later and having peace of mind, I'd much rather do that than live in such an evil world. And I just think that it's the younger people is ones I'm concerned about. Younger people think that I'm out for some motive. I'm not out for some motive. I'm out to help young people as best I can. A lot of young people, in my opinion, need guidance. They need support. They need encouragement. They need the opportunity to find their own journey and to have role models. And that's what I'm trying to do. I have no motive for money. I have no motive for any other agendas. The only motives I have are to make love and kindness and compassion in the world today. And if you don't like that, well, I'm sorry, but that's just the way that I think. And I don't want to compromise on my values and my standards just in order to meet the insecurities and the deficits in other people. You know, that's just not the way I operate. So thanks very much for watching, and it's Australia Day here, so I hope everybody's having a good Australia Day. I don't want to get involved in the other discussions about Australia Day. Just hope that people, I pray for goodness, and I pray that people have a great day today and have some joy and happiness. Thank you very much for watching.